Kurunji Senior Secondary School, CBSE, Namakkal.
Successful, result-producing school in state every year.
Administered by the Board of Directors with over 35 years of experience in the teaching field.
Special attention on art, craft, music, dance, silambam, yoga, skating and karate.
Focus on Hindi Sabha and Spell Bee Olympiad exams.
Smart class for effective and innovative learning and well-furnished library.
Solitary importance on sports and games in state and national level.
WhatsApp facilities to know activities of students and school inside the campus.
NEET, JEE, IIT coaching experts from Rajasthan and Andhra Pradesh along with our effective teachers.
Admission, registration for classes LKG to plus 2.
Kurunji Educational Institution, Kavetipatti, Namakkal. Admission in progress. CBSE, KG to 12th, contact 9025895176. Metric, 6 to 12th, contact 9344567484. For online admission, log on to www.kurunjischoolnkl.in.
In continuation to the last class, in this class we are going to discuss the important relation in this chapter, thermal properties of matter, which is Newton's law of cooling, okay ma, right. See, in our day-to-day life, you know, at the time of especially in winter, right? See, when we used to take tea or coffee at the time of morning, 6 o'clock or 7 o'clock, suppose if there is less time to take to drink either tea or coffee, generally what can we do, right? There is only short time, that is what, less than 1 minute, like that, otherwise 1 minute. See, the tea or coffee is very hot, you know. How to take the tea or coffee within short time means usually we are taking the same tea or cup, same tea or coffee in a plate like material. Generally we used to take in a cup, no, or glass. Instead of that cup or glass, we are going to take in a plate like material which has a larger surface area, right? Then automatically, you know, when the surface area is more, the speed of evaporation, the decreasing of temperature for a particular substance, whether it is tea or coffee, right, will be the time will be very less. So within the less amount of time, the temperature will fallen shortly. So then automatically it is easy to take coffee or tea. So generally we need a normal temperature to take fast, right? Just like water. That's why what I am saying is, instead of taking in a cup or glass, if you take in a plate like material, because of increasing the surface area, the temperature of that particular tea or coffee will come to fall shortly or suddenly within less amount of time, so that it is easy to take within short interval of time, right? So this is the general application in our daily life. Here in this application, in this example, we are getting the importance of Newton's law of cooling. Newton's law of cooling, right? See, now I am going to say, we all know that hot water or milk, when left on a table, begins to cool gradually. Is it correct or not? Suppose in office or in our home, wherever it is, we know very well, hot water or hot milk, when left on a table, begins to cool gradually. See, what is happening there? Ultimately, it attains the temperature of the surroundings. Is it fact or not? Right? Definitely, it attains the surroundings temperature. To study how a given body can cool on exchanging heat with its surroundings, now we are going to discuss one particular activity, right? So it is what we experience in our daily life. When you keep a cup of coffee or tea or milk, which is very, very hot. See, if we keep there and you go and you come after certain time, means, so that temperature of that particular either coffee or tea or milk will becomes to decrease, and finally it attains the surroundings temperature. This is what happening. This is what we are seeing. We experienced many times in our daily life. Okay. See, now we are going to discuss one activity to discuss, right? We are going to discuss now one activity to discuss or to study how a given body can cool on exchanging heat with its surroundings. Heat with its surroundings, right? So what is the system? What are the surroundings? We already got conclusion from our previous classes, right? Okay, but here the important point is there is a chance for the heat to go from system to the surroundings or from the substance to the surroundings, right? Now, listen carefully. Now we are going to discuss one important activity to study how a given body can cool on exchanging heat with its surroundings. Okay, right. Take some water, for example 300 ml in a calorimeter with a stirrer and cover it with two hole lid, right? I'll repeat once again because already we discussed calorimeter. Take some water, for example 300 ml in a calorimeter with a stirrer and cover it with two hole lid. Right, now fix a thermometer through a hole. Fix a thermometer through a hole in the lid and make sure that the bulb of the thermometer is immersed in the water. So please listen carefully. Take two hole calorimeter with 300 ml of water. That is the first step. And next one is, we have to insert the thermometer. We have to fix a thermometer through a hole in the lid and make sure that the bulb of the thermometer must be immersed in the water. That is. Next one, note the reading of the thermometer, right? Here you can see, what is the thermometer and what is the calorimeter. Here you can see, right? So after noting down the reading of the thermometer, this reading is the temperature T1 of the surroundings. This reading T1 is the temperature of the surroundings, right? Now, heat the water kept in the calorimeter till it attains a temperature, say 40 degrees centigrade. That is what generally ordinary temperature or room temperature means 27 degrees centigrade, no? Right, but we are going to heat the water which is present in the calorimeter up to 40 degrees centigrade, right? Okay. Now, we stop heating the water by removing the heat source. See, with the help of either whatever it may be, the heating element, whether gas stove, right, whether electric stove, whatever it may be. Usually, we are in our chemistry lab, physics lab, we are using like gas-like material nowadays, okay, right. Ipo, see, we have to stop the heating of the water by removing the heat source, right? Now, start the stopwatch and note the reading of the thermometer after fixed interval of time. Say, after every minute of stirring, gently with a stirrer. So, we have to stir the content which is present in the calorimeter gently and we have to note down the reading of the thermometer for every minute. Okay, right. Now, continue to note down the temperature T2 of water till it attains a temperature about 5 degrees centigrade above that of the surroundings. See, first it is the T1 temperature, that is what temperature of the surroundings. Now, we are going to note down the time taken to decrease the temperature from T1 to T2. T2 means which is just 5 degrees centigrade more than the temperature of the surroundings. Okay, that is one thing. And now we are going to plot a graph. See here, this is the graph, right? You can see. Now we are going to draw a graph. This is the graph which shows the temperature difference. This is delta T means temperature difference, that is 0 degree centigrade generally. See, it is T2 minus T1. By taking T2 minus T1 on y-axis and time on x-axis, we are going to draw a graph, right? See, from this graph, what we are getting? What is the information we are getting from this graph? Can you tell me? Right. See, from this graph, we can say that how the cooling of hot water depends on the temperature of its temperature, depends on the difference in the temperature of its and to the surroundings. Okay. Right? Are you getting my point? See, for example, I have a glass of water, but water is at 50 degrees centigrade. I have another glass of water, but water is at 40 degrees centigrade. Can you tell me which of these two will become to reach room temperature shortly? That's what my question. So here the thing is how, how the cooling of hot water depends on the difference of its temperature from that of the surroundings. That is the thing we understood. See here. Here you can notice that initially the rate of cooling is higher. See this. From here to here, the rate of cooling is higher. But slowly what happens? It will be decreased. So initially the rate of cooling is higher and decreases as the temperature of the body falls. See here the temperature difference is high now. Here the temperature difference is low now. So the rate of cooling is decreasing with time. That is the conclusion we have to draw from the graph. See how we are drawing this graph? From the activity just now what we discussed with the help of calorimeter and thermometer. Now, see here, the activity what we discussed shows that a hot body loses heat to its surroundings in the form of heat radiation. The hot body loses heat in the form of radiation. And at the same time, we also can say that the rate of loss of heat depends on the difference in temperature between the body and its surroundings. The rate of loss of heat depends on the difference in temperature between the body and its surroundings. That is the important point we noticed from the activity what we discussed. Next, Newton was the first scientist to study in a systematic manner the relation between the heat lost by a body in a given enclosure and its temperature. I'll repeat once again. Newton was the first to study in a systematic manner the relation between the heat lost by a body in a given enclosure and its temperature. Okay, right. Now, see, we are going for mathematical treatment. According to Newton's law of cooling, the rate of loss of heat, that is what symbolically minus dq by dt of the day, of the body. See here, according to Newton's law of cooling, the rate of loss of heat, that is what minus dq by dt minus. So see here, according to Newton's law of cooling, the rate of loss of heat minus dq by dt of the body is directly proportional to the difference of temperature, that is T2 minus T1 of the body and the surroundings. Okay, right. Now, this law holds good only for small difference of temperature, and also you can say the loss of heat by radiation depends upon the nature of surface of the body, and the area of the exposed surface. So here three things we are pointing out. One is difference in temperature, another one is nature of the surface, and the last one is area of the exposed surface. Okay, right. See, now you can write this expression, that is minus dq by dt is equal to k into T2 minus T1. Here k is the positive constant which depends upon the area and nature of the surface of the body, right? Okay. Now, for example, suppose if there is a body of mass m and specific heat capacity S is at temperature T2, for example, right? Suppose a body of mass small m and specific heat capacity small s is at temperature T2, full stop. Let T1 be the temperature of the surroundings. If the temperature falls by a small amount dT2 in time dt, that is dT2 in time dt, then the amount of heat lost So what is the amount of heat loss? dQ is equal to ms into dT2. Actually, Emma, this is the formula. Q is equal to ms delta T. See here, what he is saying means there is a body of mass small m and specific heat capacity small s, which is at a temperature T2, and T1 be the temperature of the surroundings. Suppose if the temperature falls by a small amount dT2 in a time dt, then the amount of heat loss dQ is equal to ms dT2. Right now, rate of loss of heat, the same thing, just we are going right in terms of rate of loss of heat. Rate means with respect to time only, no? dQ by dT is equal to ms dT2 by dt. That is another equation. It is one equation, right? From these two equations, you can write this one. Minus ms into dT2 by dt is equal to k into T2 minus T1, right? Now, next. dT2 by T2 minus T1 is equal to minus k by ms into dt. This is what we are taking, this ms to this side. See, mass is a constant, no? Specific heat capacity of a one particular substance is constant, no? Right. Next, k is already a constant, right? Now, because k is a positive constant, here I told you, no? Right. Now, see this k, see instead of small k, we have keep capital K, but anyhow, it is a constant. See, these three are constants. And this is a new constant which is in terms of these three, right? Ipu, where k is equal to k by ms, where k is equal to k by ms, okay, that is. Now we are going to integrate this equation on both the sides, ma, so that we are getting log T2 minus T1 to the base e is equal to minus k into t plus c. So finally, T2 is equal to T1 plus c dash into e to the power of minus kt, where c dash is equal to e to the power of c. C dash is equal to e to the power of c. Okay, ma? This is like one more equation. And new equation, the final equation what we are getting here. Right. Now, in this case, see, this equation, whatever the equation we have here, this equation enables us to calculate the time of cooling of a body through a particular range of temperature. This equation enables us to calculate the time of cooling of a body through a particular range of temperature. Okay, that is one thing. And next, you know, for small temperature differences, the rate of cooling due to conduction, convection and radiation combined is proportional to the difference in temperature. For small temperature differences, the rate of cooling due to conduction, convection and radiation combined is proportional to the difference in temperature. Okay, that is one thing. And you know, this relation, this Newton's law, is a valid approximation in the transfer of heat from a radiator to a room. The loss of heat through the wall of a room or the cooling of a cup of tea on the table, right? This law holds good in these applications. So application one, what he is saying is transfer of heat from a radiator to a room. And second application, what he is saying is cooling of a cup of tea on the table, right? See, anyhow, you can say that this Newton's law of cooling holds good for small temperature differences, okay, right? Now, you can also say, see, the Newton's law of cooling can also be verified with the help of experimental setup, right? That's what we already discussed. That is what calorimeter and taking water like that, okay? And the small arrangement, right? That is not only, but there is a small arrangement. So with this setup also you can use. What is this setup means? This I already showed you, but once again. Here we have two, right? This setup consists of a double walled vessel containing water in between the two walls, right? A copper calorimeter C containing hot water is placed inside the double walled vessel. That is one thing. And the two thermometers through the corks are used. Two thermometers through the corks are used to note the temperatures T2 of the water in calorimeter and T1 of hot water in between the double walls respectively. Now, first, the temperature of hot water in the calorimeter is noted after equal intervals of time. After completion of this, you can draw a graph between T2 minus T1, log E to the base T2 minus T1, log T2 minus T1 to the base E, and this is the time. So if you draw a graph, then we are getting like this. This is the curve. So the nature of the graph is observed to be a straight line having a negative slope. See, what I discussed to you, the calorimeter and thermometer in the initial time of this class, and now just there is a small change. Here we have two thermometers to measure temperatures, here T1 and here T2. That is the only difference. Main mechanism is same. Right, now we are going to discuss the next continuation example, example 11.8. Okay, see here. A pan filled with hot food cools from 94 degrees centigrade to 86 degrees centigrade in 2 minutes. A pan filled with hot food cools from 94 degrees centigrade to 86 degrees centigrade in 2 minutes when the room temperature is at 20 degrees centigrade. Full stop. How long will it take to cool from 71 degrees centigrade to 69 degrees centigrade? So the same hot food to cool from 94 degrees centigrade to 86 degrees centigrade takes 2 minutes when the room temperature is 20 degrees centigrade. But at the same room temperature, how long will it take to cool from 71 degrees centigrade to 69 degrees centigrade? That is the question. Okay, right, see here. See, what is the average temperature of 94 degrees centigrade and 86 degrees centigrade? The average temperature is, right? The average temperature of 94 degrees centigrade and 86 degrees centigrade is 90 degrees centigrade, because 94 plus 86 by 2. That is 70 degrees centigrade. Okay. See, this 70 degrees centigrade is, right? This 70 degrees centigrade is above room temperature now. Under these conditions, you know, the pan cools 8 degrees centigrade in 2 minutes. See, this is what the difference now, because 8 degrees centigrade means under these conditions the pan cools. See, from 94 to 86, it takes 2 minutes. That's what they have given already, right? Now, we are using one equation, that's what we had in the same class. This is what, right? I have written once again. See, by using this equation, what can we say in terms of letters? That is what, change in temperature by time is equal to K into delta T. See, change in temperature is 80 degrees centigrade, 94 to 86 by 2 minutes. And this is what, K into 70 degrees centigrade is the average temperature. Now, the same thing we are going to apply for the next situation, what we have to compute or calculate. That is 71 degrees centigrade to 69 degrees centigrade, right? See, 79 degrees centigrade, 69 degrees centigrade, what is the average temperature? See here, that is 70, no? Because 71 plus 69 by 2, that is what, 70 degrees centigrade, which is 50 degrees centigrade above the room temperature, am I right? Because the room temperature is 20 degrees centigrade. So, K is the same for this situation as for the original. See, what can we write here? 2 degrees centigrade divided by time we have to calculate, is equal to K into 50 degrees centigrade. This is the equation 2. See, equation 1, equation 2, from these two equations, 1 by 2 gives 8 degrees centigrade per 2 minutes divided by 2 degrees centigrade by time, is equal to K into 70 by K into 50, right? So, K will get cancelled, 0, 0 will get 7 by 5 here, 8 by 2 minutes, no, right, time. 0.7 minutes, this side 0.7, see, finally, right, after completion of the mathematical calculation, right, finally we are getting time as 0.7 minutes. See, 0.7 minute means how many seconds, that's you calculate, because 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So, this you can write it as 7 by 10 into 60. So, 10, 60, right, so 6 will be there, finally 7, 6, it will be 42 seconds, right. So, here, time taken for hot food to cool from 71 degrees centigrade to 69 degrees centigrade at the room temperature of 20 degrees centigrade is 42 seconds, right? This is what we are experiencing generally when we come to school, right? So, the tiffin or something is very hot, but there is less time for school bus, right? So, there every day we are experiencing when we are coming to school. Sometimes afternoon also, right? As a Sunday, after preparing, immediately you want to eat, means if it is too hot, you cannot, right? So, there we are experiencing the situation, how much time it will take to cool, okay? Right. Thank you. So, with this class, we completed the chapter thermal properties of matter. Okay, so in the next class, in the coming class, we are going to start next continuation chapter, that is thermodynamics. Okay, ma? Right. Thank you.